Microlecture 9, The Rise of the Enlightenment. The political, intellectual, and religious developments of the early modern period that gave rise to the scientific revolution further contribute to a series of debates about crucial issues in the late 17th and 18th century. These debates in Europe and the world came to be known as the Enlightenment. The Reformation conflicts and the consolidation of a global world increased questions about political sovereignty and its limits. Additionally, the movement of people, goods, and ideas among Asia, Africa, Europe, and the Americas offered the opportunity to recognize different ways of life and values. The scientific revolution's tremendous achievements inspired intellectuals to believe that answers to all the questions could be found through the use of rational and critical thinking. Progress became a possibility for all human beings. The European Enlightenment was a broad intellectual and cultural movement that gained strength gradually and did not reach its maturity until about 1750. Its origins can be attributed to a combination of factors including political opposition to absolutist rule, religious conflicts between Protestants and Catholics, and the desire to apply principles and practices from the scientific revolution to human society. A key space for the early Enlightenment was the Dutch Republic. It was there that many Protestant thinkers moved due to the intolerance climate that was common in Catholic Europe at the time. The tolerance of the Dutch Republic allowed them to resettle, but also gave them enough freedom to openly criticize governments and challenge authority based on political and religious issues. In this context, important philosophers and writers like Pierre Bayle and Baruch Spinoza began to apply natural philosophy and scientific thought to society. For example, Spinoza believed that mind and body were united in one substance and that God and nature were merely two names for the same thing. He envisioned a deterministic universe in which good and evil were merely relative values and outside circumstances, not free will-shaped human actions. Out of these periods came John Locke's essay concerning human understanding, in which he set forth a new theory about how human beings learn and form their ideas. According to Locke, all ideas are derived from experience. Therefore, human development is determined by external forces like education and social institutions, not innate characteristics. In many places, the circulation of new ideas was viewed as subversive, which is why different authors at the time wrote novels, plays, histories, and philosophies as a way to escape censorship and persecution. One remarkable example is that of the Baron of Montesquieu, who used his literary work to criticize Europe, its practices and beliefs openly. In The Spirits of Laws, his most important piece, Montesquieu used the critical method to understand the problem of government. He argued that forms of government were shaped by history, geography, and customs. Montesquieu identified three main types of government: monarchies, republics, and despotism. He also argued in favor of the separation of powers. Another famous thinker of this era was Voltaire. He wrote more than 70 volumes and it was well known for his radicalism. Voltaire believed in God, but he rejected the church and hated religious intolerance, which he felt led to fanatism and cruelty. An important contribution to Enlightenment thinking came from the Swiss intellectual Jean-Jacques Rousseau, who passionately committed to individual freedom but attacked rationalism and civilization as destroying rather than liberating the individual. Rousseau's contribution to political theory in the social contract was based on two fundamental concepts, the general will and popular sovereignty. The book that perhaps characterizes the spirit of the Enlightenment the most was the Encyclopedia, titled Encyclopedia, the Rational Dictionary of the Science, the Arts and the Craft. The 17-volume text was edited by Denis Diderot and Jean-Laurent de Lambert. Completed in 1765, the encyclopedia contained hundreds of thousands of articles by leading scientists, writers, skilled workers, and progressive priests. The Enlightenment was a movement of international dimensions, with thinkers traversing borders in a constant exchange of visits, letters, and printed materials. The circulation of these ideas reached a global audience who fed on them and also reproduced them. Besides the many political, philosophical, and economic discussions that were part of the Enlightenment, two major themes captured intellectuals' attention: the place of women in society and the debate on race. The question of women's proper role in society and the nature of gender differences fascinated Enlightenment thinkers. Some philosophers champion greater rights and expand education for women, claiming that women's position and treatment were the best indicators of a society's level of civilization and decency. Women writers made crucial contributions, and in a more informal role, many women helped circulating ideas in cafes, stores, and informal gatherings. However, most male thinkers of the era espoused only modest reforms that did not challenge male superiority over women. As scientists and intellectuals were developing taxonomies of the natural and the social world, they also began to classify humans into hierarchical order races. Influential Enlightenment thinkers such as David Hume and Immanuel Kant promote racist ideas based on their perception that white Europeans were naturally superior. The use of the word race to designate biological distinct groups of humans was new in European thought. Previously, Europeans had grouped other peoples into nations based on their historical, political, and cultural affiliations rather than on a supposedly innate physical difference. These ideas had profound effects on the consolidation of the modern world, since the concept that some groups of people are biologically superior continues to be the justification for racism and oppression. As a cultural, political, intellectual, and social phenomenon, the Enlightenment was decisive for the consolidation of the modern world. The impact of the ideas circulated at the time continues to be important even today. This is all we have for today. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.